was given talent, balls were just too late. So they try to put me down, but it makes me more ambitious. Success is sweet, but revenge is so delicious. Skiers gonna hate.
What's going on, everyone? Starters back with another pregame stats breakdown. Starting off on the red team, we're going to have Lux, Master Yi, Varus, Singed, and Zyra versus the blue team, who has Diana, Fizz, Amumu, Misfortune, and Blitzcrank. So at the top lane, we're going to have a matchup with Singed versus Fizz, a very interesting matchup, but Singed mains jungle while Fizz mains top, so this should give Fizz a little bit of an advantage. But Singed's been played by this person 77 times, which is actually quite a bit. On the other hand, Fizz has been played by this person 99 times. So I think overall, I will have to give the advantage to Fizz just because he has more experience in that top lane, even though I know Volt Ninja is a fantastic player. Then if we go into the mid lane, we are going to have Lux versus Diana. Now this is also another pretty interesting match because Lux can zone a lot with her spells against Diana since she's melee for the most part. So Lux mains AD carry while Diana mains caster. This should give Pobelter a little bit of an advantage. But Lux has been played by this person 23 times, whereas as to where Diana's only been played by this person 4 times. So I'm a little bit worried, but I think I'm still going to have to give the advantage to Diana on this one. If we go into the jungle, we're going to have Master Yi versus Amumu, which is also a pretty interesting matchup. Master Yi mains support while Amumu mains top, so neither of them are going to really have an advantage at all. Master Yi's only been played by this person 3 times, which is a super low game count for a champion, especially one that's been out since like beta. And Amumu's been played by this person 52 times. So I think I'm definitely going to give the advantage to Amumu in this one. Then if we take a look at the bottom lane, last but not least, for AD carries, we're going to have Varus versus Misfortune. Now, Varus mains AD carry while Misfortune also mains AD carry, so that means it's going to be really, really close. Varus has been played by this person 33 times, where Misfortune has only been played by this person 14 times, so it's a little bit less than half. I think I'll have to give the advantage a little bit more into Varus just because he has a little bit more of a range and more of a stable, pokey situation. But then if we take a look at the supports, now this is kind of where it gets a little important. We're going to have a Zyra support versus Blitzcrank support. Zyra mains caster while Blitzcrank mains support. So it's really kind of hard to say, but Blitzcrank should have a pretty big advantage since he's used to playing in that bottom lane. Zyra's been played by this person 7 times, where Blitzcrank has also only been played by this person 7 times. So it's low game counts on both sides. Overall, I really think the fact that Blitzcrank main support is greatly going to help out the Misfortune. I just don't know if it's going to outweigh the fact that Varus should, in theory, beat Misfortune. But overall, if you add up the wins and losses of everybody on both teams, you're going to see that the red team has an average of 59.87% chance of winning, as to where the blue team has a 57.49% chance of winning, which is very high, high, high numbers. So it should be a really interesting match, but I think I'm going to go with the numbers, vote for the red team. Let's go ahead and get in the game and see what happens, shall we? Hey, what's going on, everyone? Starters back with another episode of the Diamond League. Today, we are following around Sia? No, we're not. Just kidding. He's not even connected to the game quite yet. I don't know if he's disconnected, but we are going to be following around Pobelter, because he is somebody we have not seen in a very long time. Plus, he's also on the same team as a Fizz, and also another champion we have not seen in a very long time. But Yi as well. Man, there's a lot of very interesting champions in this particular game. I don't know what all is going to come of this, because anything can really happen. After Singed's nerf, I haven't actually seen him be played yet, so I don't know how significant it is. A lot of people say it's huge, which I'm kind of on the fence, because anytime you're dealing with percentages, it kind of depends on what percentage, or like what the total number is based on that percentage. Because if you're taking away like 5% of 1, it's like nothing. Or if you're taking away 10% of 1, it's like nothing. But if you're taking like 10% from 1,000, it's a bigger number, but overall, it's still really nothing. Because it's just 10%, so it's really hard to say if it's actually going to be anything crazy or not. So I'm really interested to actually see what he does. But a jungle Master Yi against a jungle Amumu, I don't see that going very well for Master Yi. He's pretty much just going to get bandage tossed unless he starts his Alpha Strike first. So he can do an Alpha Strike and kind of immune the bandage toss, but I don't know what's going to happen after that because he's most likely just going to get caught out. The great thing about this is that there are like six people in Challenger in this one game. So it's not going to be a very low level game. It should be very interesting. So that's what I'm excited about. But if Sia never reconnects, this is going to be a very bad news bears situation for the red team. Because Lux is a very vital part of their entire team. Just because she does so much burst, she can burst down a target really easily, like Misfortune, Fizz, it's going to lock him down. She can actually get him in the Light Binding, which is going to be the difficult part, because he has that Playful Trickster that he'll be able to kind of run around for a little bit and avoid it, but if he's unable to do that, then they're going to be in a pretty tough situation. Yeah, if you can't Playful Trickster out of the Light Binding, he's most likely he will die pretty quickly, if not instantly. But that was really cool. Yay, Lux came back. Just in time for the game to start. Blue team probably had a pretty big advantage and a good chance of actually. Nice try getting on the Grasping Roots, but I don't really know if you want to initiate down straight onto Blitzcrank Misfortune. They probably knew that they weren't there, so it's not a big deal. Forest actually not skilling up anything yet. I'm kind of surprised he didn't throw out like a hail of arrows or a piercing arrow. So there's going to be wardens traverse from both teams, but the one from the red team is almost already halfway gone. Were these explorer wards? Yeah, okay. So they're explorer wards, and that's why they're going down so quickly. Just to kind of prevent any form of aggression coming up from either team. Couple really nice double strikes for Master Yi. It's gonna help a lot if he continues to be able to get those. And as you can see, he cleared those holes super fast with the help of Zyra and Varus. Yeah, he's doing a great job. That's gonna be scary crazy. Gonna put on that Wuju style, get that increased attack damage. And I don't know what will happen at that point. That could be really, really scary for a nice early gank. If he ganks top lane with Singed, I think he'll have to level Playful Trickster at level 2. I think Fizz will pretty much have to do that. If he doesn't, he's going to be in a really tough situation. He is melee just like Singed, but and he does have quite a bit of mobility. And that's a little bit what I'm worried about. Great grab. Looks like it landed on Zyra. She's going to have to use her heal already. Doesn't actually throw out the flash, but actually ends up healing. So that's dangerous. And like I said, Master Yi's coming in for the gank, doing quite a bit of damage. Going to get a nice... Oh, first blood coming down for Master Yi. One of the earlier champions that you definitely never wanted to feed. He can still get extremely, extremely dangerous if he gets fed, but chances of that are just not as likely as it used to be. Just because there's a lot more counters and there's no real way to ban him out completely anymore. Or ban out his counters completely. Back in the day, there was just not that many champions, and Master Yi was very difficult to deal with. They've changed him quite a bit, and that's all that really matters. What matters is now. Mumu coming in, trying to go for this early gank. I don't know if it's gonna happen. We do have... I think Mumu... Oh, beautiful bandage toss going down, getting quite a bit of damage. Auto attack coming out. If there was a flash with a possible ignite, that could have helped... Possibly, she doesn't have her Prismatic Barrier yet. So no shield for Luxus could be dangerous. Oh, no. It's going a little crazy. But he's keeping a huge zone so that Lux isn't getting any experience. And Diana's able to feed. Nice Alpha Strike. Oh, beautiful Light Binding. Going to get the Ignite down. And oh, Diana might go down from this. Oh, she goes at 12 HP. Beautiful survivability. Is anything else gonna happen? There's no laser coming out from Lux. She's not level 6 yet. Oh, but in the meantime... bottom lane. Couldn't tell which lane it was. It's hard to tell when there's fights going on all over the place in all three lanes. Oh, nice! Wow, beautiful. All the plants doing so much damage. His mana barrier is just not enough. She's going to flash to help get a bit in that kill, but just wasn't quite enough. I don't know if flash was really necessary. I think Varus would have been able to take care of it pretty much by himself. Lux is being pinged to back off. She still has her flash open, so I don't know what they're freaking out about necessarily. But yeah, don't exactly know what's going on. Diana's still super, super low. She's chugging down those health potions like there's no tomorrow. She does pick up she has a mana potion as well, so that will also definitely help. And Diana's only up by 3 CS at this point. She is also down by a level, which is very surprising since Lux was zoned out for quite some time. So I'm a little bit surprised at that, but she will have some part of an advantage. Lux gets spotted out by this ward. They pretty much know that she put a ward down here since it's not in her inventory anymore once they came back. And they know exactly where she went and where she stopped and where she turned back. So they know it's like right around here. Nobody pinged it out, but that may have been one of those common knowledge calls. There were no fights going on, so there's nothing really distracting them from anything. And that's kind of a judgment call you have to make. Either nobody noticed it. Oh, yeah. See, Mumu didn't notice it, or he notices it now. And he's like, oh, yeah, I forgot that they have a ward there. And this could be a gank. But the red team is pushed way too far back. There's nothing they're going to be able to do for that. Top lane once again going for a pretty crazy exchange. Yeah, Fizz doing as much damage as he can just from his auto attacks. The poison does quite a bit of damage, but it's nothing too crazy quite yet since it's only level 1. He's going for the Urchin Strike first, which I find pretty surprising. Yeah, that is actually pretty weird. Oh no, once again, Blitzcrank getting completely cut out of position. Exhaust coming out. I don't know if that's going to help. Yeah, that's definitely not going to help. Nice Power Fist. Is he going to be able to get away? Oh, beautiful Mana Shots coming out. And wow, he does make it out of there. Beautiful play. With the help of Amumu, he was no longer forever alone. But, oh no. Zyra killed Misfortune. That just looked weird. It looked like she killed her own teammate. I didn't even see that happen. How did that even happen? Yeah, okay, so Miss Fortune is just super, super low. She's gonna run through there, and a nice plank coming out, doing quite a bit of damage. And wow, just one more auto attack. Oh, that barrier, so close. Boop. Just the tail end of it, able to get it all out there, but blue team is pinging off Zyra. They know that she's there. They're not gonna be able to do any form of recovery from that. Blue team's now down by 2,000 gold already at 7 minutes in. This is not a very good start for the blue team whatsoever. So hopefully they can come back in here, but Fizz isn't doing all that great. He's still winning in CS though. He's down as far as kills go for the most part. Cinch has one more assist, so he has a little bit of experience from that. And oh my gosh, bottom lane once again, a huge tower dive going directly onto that Blitzcrank, and Misfortune will fall down right after that. That is 100% depressing. The bottom lane on the blue side is just getting absolutely demolished. And wow, the minions might be able to take this out, but no, I think it's just going to barely survive. With this new wave of minions coming in, it should be able to stop that from going down anytime soon. I'm surprised that the red team hasn't made a move onto the dragon yet. For the most part, they don't really have to. I think shutting down the lanes is a little bit more effective. They definitely want to keep shutting down this bottom lane. As long as they can keep that completely shut down, prevent her from farming, and all that, yeah, it's just not going to be a good time. The spells are going down, but is Diana going to be able to come back from it? Just a little bit of damage. He's coming in, gets lightbinded, and now here comes the double damage. Are they gonna be able to get away? Diana's getting slowed by the red buff, and yes, she does finally get away. She's able to clean up the minions just in case they decide to dive, they're going to take tower shots a lot sooner. But meanwhile, at bottom lane, it looks like Blitzcrank taking quite a bit of damage once again. Gets a nice grab and a beautiful play, but Blitzcrank does end up going down in a nice Curse of the Sad Money. Going to get a Banished House down on the Zyra and trying to slow her down just a little bit with that red buff. And yes, he will get... Oh, nice flash across that. Beautiful play, double kill for the Amumu, and it just doesn't get any better than that. Diana once again getting chased down by the E. Is he going to be able to punk it up? No, that is going to be a flash. Singed in the meantime, going down, popping his ghost, and is... he didn't wait long enough, and now he just dies. Just died because he did not wait. He playful trickstered into the bush and then jumped instantly through it because he thought Singed was still going to go that way, and that's a very common mistake that a lot of people do because it is two button presses for the playful trickster, one for playful, one for trickster. So if you're going to the bush, I mean, there was no way that Singed was going to get away if he closed the gap with the flash and a playful trickster and he was at like one hit at the time. If he would have just landed that playful trickster and possibly an auto attack, it would have been done. Ooh, so close. Ends up going down, and wow, Lux taking a ton of damage. She's gonna throw on that shield and the laser, picking up the kill. Did she? Oh no, she didn't get a level, but she goes down to 75 HP. Beautiful play from Lux, and that is going to be the blue tower going down already at the bottom lane. And for a 2-on-2, going down at 10 minutes 40 seconds, that is so early. And it's already 2 kills to 8. It's been about a kill a minute. Oh man, this is not good for Fizz. But he does have playful trickster. He's going to be able to get out there, even if there's any threats. But oh man, Zyra and Varus coming from the back of Amumu. Is any of this going to happen? No, Amumu's going to run directly straight up into his teammate. Whoa. He tries to bandage toss onto it, but just barely misses it. And now, oh man, he does end up going down. Is he gonna be able to get away? No, auto attacks are too strong. Wow, the red buff is doing so much work, able to slow it down. Oh, piercing arrow doing the deeps after three of those blight strikes going down. It's gonna do quite a bit of burst. Bam! Blue team recalled. Nothing too crazy going on quite yet. Still no dragon attempt from the red team. I'm very shocked at this. But wow, blue team loses one more tower. This time it's going to be the top lane. Their last tower alive is going to be that middle tower. And it's at half HP. Oh, Lux trying to juke it. Ends up just barely juking it. Jukes the grab as well. Not quite being able to put on the harass, but that's okay. As long as she doesn't get caught out of position. So that's a messed up position to be in. Definitely one of the big ones you don't want to be involved in. Oh, that's gonna be another nice Alva strike, and bam, really easy to kill for Varus, Yi, and Lux. That's just really not a lot of help. Wow, a ton of damage. Playful trickster should coming out, and those plants doing quite a bit. Oh, they see Singed doing his blue. Are they gonna be able to steal it? Oh, I can't see if they stole it or not. Oh, but Miss Fortune coming in the mix. Is she gonna throw out the bullet time? That is the question. She's gonna throw in this auto attack as much as possible. And oh yeah, the bullet time finally coming out, but it looks like it may be too late. She's gonna get snared and then flung into her teammates. And wow, Singed just tanked through that entire thing. So far it doesn't seem that Singed is very much giving a shit about getting that nerf. Oh, nice ult combo between both members of the bottom lane, and wow, the he actually used flash. I don't know exactly what he's going for there. It's possible he's trying to flash over the wall and just didn't quite make it, or if he was messing around. He didn't have his ultimate, so he wasn't going for any sort of crazy turnaround damage.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Oh man, red team stealing the red book, doing a great job. But starting off at the top lane, let's go ahead and compare how big of a difference this is so far. So right now, oh my god, 9,000 gold behind. The blue team is 9,000 gold behind. That's horrible. Ooh, a nice grab actually landing directly on his arrow. Oh my gosh. Blitzcrank going down pretty quickly. And now, yeah, that's going to be a really easy pickup for Zyra. Oh, Yi throwing on the Yomu's Ghostblade, being able to pick that up super, super easily. And bam. Yeah, that was one of the easiest kills. Ooh, trying to get the lightbinding in. Oh man, that is going to be a shark attack. Finally getting a dragon, and no, Lux has disconnected once again. Hopefully it's not because of a rage quit, because that would be embarrassing. But you never know. This is live television. I'm just kidding. But top lane, Fizz is tied with Singed when it comes to kills, but he's also down by about 50 CS, which is 100% significant. That is so much gold.
A summoner has reconnected.
Yeah, it's a little bit crazy how much more gold that is. You know, he's up by 2,200 gold so far. Still nothing too crazy happening right now, though. Ooh, could have a really big setup, a nice flash could grab, actually grabs him away, but is able to pick it up with a nice playful trickster, and that's going to be an ultimate from Dan, trying to get out of the fight, but definitely not going to happen. And now they're completely chased by Singed. Combo from Amumu and Misfortune doing a lot of damage, and Blitzcrank getting caught out once again. Is he gonna go down? Oh, Fizz may go down. No, he gets a heal from something. I don't know if that was a level or what happened. Oh my gosh, Misfortune almost picks up the kill and Lux with a double up. Insane fight. 7-20 is a nice little 2-for-2 going on there, but there was a lot lower people as far as health goes on the blue team. But in the jungle's actually pretty even when it comes to kills, deaths. The only difference is the one assist that Yi has that Amu doesn't. So it's not really that big of a difference at all, if any. But at this point in time, Diana is up by about 20 CS. Oh, sorry. Yeah, about 20 CS. Pretty close, but is also down by 4 kills and 6 assists. So not doing too great. Blitzcrank is going to go for the grab. Ends up missing it. And oh no, the ultimate coming out. And boom, that's going to be an instant snipe. Oh, and beautiful shark attack. Doing a great job. Gonna flash before they get caught, and oh my god, this is doing so much damage. Doing as much as possible. It's not gonna be enough. The shield is gonna be way too fat. Gonna slow him just a little bit. Is it gonna be enough? No, the laser, no. Ooh, it's a nice try by Lux. Wow, this whole thing is just a tough situation for everybody. Blue team's getting caught out in the weirdest places. Like, Diana's trying to go for the move, kind of. She pushed it through, but oh man, this is not gonna look good. Yomu's and Ghost. Those are two extremely fast champions. I don't know if there's anything. Oh, the grab almost gets him. Ooh, nice grab going down. And Krista's head mommy coming out. Oh, she interrupts her ultimate, but she's still going to pick up the kill. Oh, piercing her just barely gets him. And he ends up falling down to the great and wonderful Fizz once again at 5-4. This is not good. Yes, Blitzcrank will follow down. And oh, she does need to get out of there. No, that's going to be a double kill. And Fizz is going to be able to follow up this time. Ooh. Beautiful. Ah.
Rampage.
Oh, that happened.
Red team double kill. Red team triple kill.
Alright, so that's triple kill. Oh, already surrender vote. Definitely 20 minutes surrender. Yeah, they were down by 14,000 gold at 20 minutes. That is irrecoverable. I don't think I've ever seen anybody recover from anything like that. I'm actually really surprised that the red team didn't have more dragon control or didn't even really... I mean, they kind of started to push lanes near the end, but they only had four towers at 20 minutes. With a 14k gold advantage, you would expect pretty much inhibitors to be down because that's so much gold, but 9 kills to 27 is pretty significant, and they all had their main people being singed. Lux and Varus had really close to 150 CS, and that is really, really good. I mean, Diana had 136, which is also really good, don't get me wrong, but it's just not quite there. Being down, I mean, Diana was up in her lane, but she was down in kills as well as quite significantly in assists. Zyra was just on top of the Grasping Roots the entire game. It's 17 assists out of 27, but it was also part of four other kills herself, so at 21 out of 27 participation, she's been doing a great job. She did a great job this game, so great job to Hai. Congratulations overall to the red team, and GG to the blue team. If you guys liked the videos and you want to see more, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. It really does help out the channel. If you have any requests for players or champions that you want to see, leave it in the comment section below. Send me a message and I will see what I can find. But definitely let me know if anything needs to be changed. And thanks for watching, guys. I will see you tomorrow. Peace.